I'm glad you could join me today. I'm in the 29th chapter of Jeremiah. Now, there's a famous verse that many times we see and hear proclaimed. It almost has become kind of a standalone verse. It says, "For I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and to give you a future and a hope." We see that as a meme on Facebook. We see that. We hear that oftentimes in preaching. But one of the things that we stand on as believers, as evangelical believers, is that a verse taken out of context is just a pretext for our own thoughts and ideas. And many times that's what's happened here, that this particular verse has been taken out of its context. Now, I'm not trying to suggest that God doesn't have a plan for us. I'm not trying to suggest that He isn't concerned for us and that He wants to give us a future and a hope. But what I often fail to hear when those verses are quoted is the rest of the passage. And this is what the rest of the passage says. "Then you will call upon me and come and pray to me, and I will hear you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart. I will be found by you, declares the Lord, and I will restore your fortunes and gather you from all the nations and all the places where I have driven you, declares the Lord, and I will bring you back to the place from which I sent you into exile." In this particular context, the purpose of God telling us that He has a plan for us and a future for us and a hope for us is so that we will seek Him with all of our hearts, so that we'll come and we'll pray to Him, so that we will engage our hearts, in the worship of the triune God. That's why He has a future and a hope for us. It's not enough just to be comforted by the fact that He knows the future, and when disasters happen and when difficult times come, to know that He understands the future. Of course He does. But He wants us to do that, to know that, so that we will come and pray to Him, so that we will turn back to Him in the integrity of our hearts and seek Him and draw near to Him and find Him. That's His desire. And that's why this particular verse is there. But very often, as I said, it's taken out of its context. It becomes almost a standalone verse. And it shouldn't be that way. It should be that this brings us comfort, because as a result of it, we turn to Him and find hope and strength and grace. And that's really what God intended when Jeremiah spoke these words, that the exiles in Babylon would understand that, yes, disaster has come. It's struck in the form of the Babylonian captivity. The things that were familiar to them were no more, and they were going to be never again coming back to that particular place themselves. But if they sought Him, if they found Him, if they searched for Him with all of their hearts, then the next generation would come back and be restored into the land that God had provided for them. It may be a little further down the road than they would have liked, but it was going to happen. You see, and that's part of the difficulty when we take this verse out of context, because we see the idea of a future and a hope as something for me, myself, right now. And yes, I have that future and I have that hope. I'm not denying that. But in the context in which Jeremiah is speaking, that hope and that future was something that was going to be given to their posterity, the next generation. And so we need to understand that this idea is so that we can seek Him, and so that we can pray to Him, so that we can be confident that that he doesn't chide us forever and he doesn't discipline us forever, but that if we will by faith turn our hearts back to him and seek him and search for him, he will provide not only for us but for the posterity that we leave. And that's the promise that God gave to Jeremiah. Again, it's not a standalone verse. It is something that should be seen in the context of that whole paragraph. You will seek him and you will find him when you search for him with all your heart. Father, I ask you to give grace to each one of us that we may seek you and that we may find you. Lord, thank you that you do promise us hope and futures. Thank you that in the midst of our disasters, you have a plan for us and a desire to use us. But may it prompt us to seek you, to search for you. And thank you, Father, that you promise to be found by us. And I praise you and I honor you for it. In the name of Jesus, amen. God bless you. Hope you have a great day.